there's a distinct relationship between percents, decimals, and fractions, and you need to be familiar with all three of these terms and how we can transfer or translate numbers from percents to decimals and fractions to percents and percents to fractions and percents to and decimals to percents. We need to be able to go back and forth between all of these different types of numbers. They all represent the same thing, but they're used in different ways. So let's get some rules straight. If we're going to write a decimal as a percent, we have to move the decimal point two places to the right and add a percent sign. In other words, if we had the decimal 0.15 and we wanted to represent that as a percent, we would move the decimal two places to the right. It would be 15, and we would add the percent sign. Pretend, if you want to remember which way to move it, that your percent sign acts like a magnet and the decimal point is a magnetic nail. If the percent sign is added, the decimal point is going to move two places toward it. If you take away the percent sign, let's say we had the number 2.5 and it was a percentage, and we wanted to represent that as a decimal, we take away the percent sign, our decimal is going to move in the opposite direction. It's going to move away from the percent sign this time, and it's going to move the same number of places, two places. This time we have to add a zero. So our number would be 0.025. If you have a percent and you want to write it as a fraction, well, any percent is really just the number that's written over 100. In other words, 16% is 16 over 100. Now, when you write fractions, we always have to check and say, can it be reduced? Well, both these numbers can be divided by the same factor, 4. I would divide 16 by 4 and I would have 4. And 100 divided by 4 is 25, so that's reducing 16 over 100 to 4 25ths. Let's do some practice at this. I want you to write the first four examples. They are percentages, and you need to write them as decimals. Remember the rule, first rule I did, turn off the tape and try translating these yourself and then check and see how you did. Next, do example 5 through 8 and change those from decimals to percents. Let's see how you did. Example number one is 41%. I want to write it as a decimal. I'm going to take away the percent sign. I'm going to move the decimal point two places to the left. It will be 0.41. Number two, same thing. When I take away the percent sign, decimal place point goes two places to the left, 0.736. For example three, same thing. Two places to the left means I have to add a zero. I have to fill in, so it's 0.006. And example four, two places to the left, well, this is a whole number, so we have to place my decimal point first. When I take away the percent sign, I move it two places to the left, I have 3.00, and that's just a whole number, so it's the number three. For example five, I'm going to be adding a percent sign, and my decimal point's going to move toward it. So I'm going to be moving it two places to the right. I'll add a zero for this one. 2.7 ends up being 270%. Number six, moving it two places to the right makes it 5.6. And, of course, I have to add my percent sign. Number seven, moving it two places to the right makes this a 44%. And number eight, I start at the whole number, the end of the whole number. So when I add two places to go to the right two places, I have to add two zeros. 12 is really 1,200%. Now, sometimes these numbers don't look right to you. Follow the rule. Don't get confused or think you're doing it wrong. Just follow the rule of which way to move the decimal point. You always move it two places. The only question is which direction. Now, when we have fractions that want to be written as percentages, one thing we have to remember, an easy way to do this is look and see. Remember that any number over 100, well, that number is the percentage. Could you easily get the fraction you're working with to have a denominator of 100? In this particular case, we can. We would say 50 times 2 would give us 100. So I can multiply my numerator times 2, and that gives me 82 one-hundredths. I know what percentage that is because it's written over 100. All I have to do is write it as a percent. Let's try number 10. Can I easily get the denominator to 100? this time it would be 10 times 10. So 9 times 10 would give me 90 over 100. As a percentage, that's 90%. Example number 11 says 4 and 1 half. And I'm really going to change that. I'm going to change it to an improper fraction. I'm going to say 4 times 2 is 8 plus 1. That gives me 9 over the same denominator. Now, can I easily get this to become a fraction with a denominator of 100? Well, I can. If I multiply each of them by 50, I will have 450 over 100, or 450%. Example number 4 is not quite so simple. Now, this number is not supposed to be 4 at the top. It's supposed to be 3 over 15. And I realize you could easily reduce that, but let's hang on. Let's just work it the way it is right now because I want to show you something. There's another way. If you can't easily get the denominator to become 100, then what you do is divide. We would say 3 15ths is really 3 divided by 15. Now, that's going to give us a decimal answer. Let's put some zeros in. 15 into 30 goes 2 times. 2 times 15 is 30. So I've got 0.2. Now I can convert 0.2 to a percent by moving the decimal point 2 places to the right, and it becomes 20%. This method that we use of division will always work. The method that we were using before, where we're taking the denominator of the fraction and making it to, getting it to 100, only works with certain numbers. But dividing a fraction to find the decimal and then changing that decimal to a percent will always work with any fraction you have.